Oh, my bad, y'all. How are you today? I hope everyone's having a wonderful morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on when you're watching this video. I deeply apologize for not paying attention to you. If you guys do not know who I am the Mademoiselle. Welcome to my channel. Today, we're going to be discussing the soft life. And speaking of the soft life, if I do seem a little bit different or I seem to be speaking differently, that is because I've decided I'm going to be partaking in the soft life. I've decided I'm going to be taking on a new persona. I'm going to be partaking in the soft life era. I've decided I no longer want to struggle. I no longer want to be masculine or strong or loud or ghetto as they like to see us in the media. I want to be soft. I want to be taken care of. I don't want anyone to do anything for me anymore. I want to do for myself and literally put self-care on the forefront. I want to be soft. And I think you guys should do that too. I want to go on lavish vacations and literally go to the spa all day, every day, and just be taken care of. You know, isn't that what you guys want too? I think that's what everyone should want. Like, is that so much to ask? Like, I feel like we've been going through so much and it's just like, I'm so tired, you know? This is so fucking much. I can't! I had a whole script, I had a whole thing written out, and I can't. Roll the intro. I'm exhausted. Jesus Christ, it's so hard to be a fake bitch.
what up, everybody? I'm the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we're gonna be talking about the soft girl era. Welcome to the real talk. Now, before we get started, we're gonna give a special thank you to the sponsor of this video, Hood Charms. They sent me their bodega bubble sandals, in which you saw featured in the beginning of this video, and I'm gonna tell you more about them towards the middle of this video, so please stay tuned. If you do want to purchase these from a black-owned business, feel free to head down to the description and or the pinned comment down below and purchase them right now. But we gotta get into the nitty-gritty because I got a lot to say about this subject. A lot of y'all gonna be mad, but I don't give a shit. For whatever reason, a lot of people don't wanna say anything about this fucking movement. And I just can't. Why everybody afraid to say something about the soft girl era? Why? Because y'all soft? I ain't soft. Like, let me tell y'all, I tried to play that stuff with my man and tried to, hi, yeah. Like, he was like, are you okay? Like, are you sick? Like, what's going on? Like, yo, my man was just looking at me like, are you good? Like, it was just the funniest thing because he was just like, you're not being yourself. Like, what the fuck? And that's the main problem I have with this. A lot of y'all are not being yourselves, and it's just so infuriating to see. Every day it's a new movement. Every day it's a new aesthetic. Every day. For what? For what? To please men? Huh? To prove to people that you're not what you are? You are whatever you are. If you're soft, you're soft. If you're not, you're not. It is what it is. But the mask is gonna slip, okay? I'm speaking from people that I've seen on social media personally, and also people that I know on a personal level that have joined this whole soft girl movement era situation. So this may not pertain to you, this may not pertain to people that you know, but this pertains to a lot of people that I know, as well as people that I know that have been affected by this, and people that are like being told that they have to be soft, being told that the way that they are is not okay because, you know, their friends are now becoming soft, and they didn't even go through a journey. They just one day was masculine, next day now they soft, and now they're telling their friends, oh, you need to be soft, that's why you ain't got a man, that's why you this, that's, it's like, bro, you know. So this video is for y'all, okay? For those of you guys that are being told like, you need to be soft, you know, you need to be this, you know, join the soft girl era, like, for those of y'all that are going through this is for you guys. Y'all don't deserve that, and it's ridiculous how we can't have nothing nice. on the surface level, this sounds like something that could be nice. It sounds like something that should be nice. And, you know, it's not. So now I gotta drag. I gotta drag. But before we get into all of that, let's just start from the beginning, okay? If you guys are not aware, the soft life was actually coined by the Nigerian influencer community, okay? According to Anscape.com, and I quote, the term soft life originated in the Nigerian influencer community as slang for living a life of comfort and low stress. That is part of what makes the soft life content so inspiring. The chance to imagine what life can feel like apart from realities of woman's labor. Now, let me just say flat out, I think women deserve peace, especially black women. I believe that we should not be burdened with having to do any and everything. And it's very unfortunate that literally from the time that we're born, we have to do any and everything for our parents, for our families, for our significant others, for our siblings, whatever the case may be. It's horrible. But does everything have to be a trend? Does everything have to be an aesthetic? Does everything have to be announced? Why can't we just be? Like, why can't we just be? And then on top of that, why do people have to be so dishonest? And I'm going to get into that in a little bit. To add to the whole soft girl era thing, understand there's kind of two parts of the soft girl era, right? There's a soft girl era that taps into the divine femininity and toxic femininity, if you really want to be real here. And then there's a soft girl era that really is becoming the soft girl to be with a man, to tap into her femininity in order to seduce men, in order to tap into the male gaze, in order to finally secure a man. I'm mainly going to be talking on that point, but I'm going to be bouncing back and forth. And it just blows my mind, because how in the hell did we go from it's a hot girl summer to I'm F-R-E-E, that spells free, I'm hanging out with my ratchet ass friend, to I'm living my soft life, I'm in my soft girl era? I don't understand. We went from one extreme to another extreme. It's fucking strange. Like, I literally have friends that have changed their whole TL. Like, they're posting completely different content. And I'm like, bitch, this ain't you. Like, this ain't you, girl. Like, it don't make sense. I didn't even know about this for a minute until, like, literally one of my friends came up to me like, oh my God, Ivana, I'm so proud of you. I see you living your soft life. I'm like, I'm living my what, bitch? What, I'm where, how? I'm like, what are you talking about, bitch? Yo, I was so confused. It was like, you know, you own your business. You got your YouTube popping. You work for yourself. Your man loves you. And, you know, you got your apartment. You got your car. You got everything together. You keep yourself together. I'm like, I always been like that, though. Don't get this shit twisted. And I still bust the bitch up their head, though. I'm still from the hood, though. So, I don't know what you're talking about. But I understand, right? I understand. Because there's different facets to the soft girl era. Okay? There's different, you know, vibes and aesthetics. But it's just like, why do we have to put a name and an aesthetic and a vibe and to everything? And bitch, you don't know my life. You don't know if I don't be shooting in the gym. You don't know if I don't be shooting people. Like, yo, what? Like, it was just so weird. I was just like, where do we get this from? And then I looked it up and I was like, I started seeing soft girl this, soft girl that. And I was like, what in the world? So to further explain, the soft girl life entails a black woman rejecting hard labor, the hard life, the stress that being a black woman entails, making choices that prioritize themselves, okay? Self-love, prioritizing self-love, self-care, rejecting sacrifice by any means necessary. And of course, like I said, tapping into being more feminine, which can also include, which is why a lot of people have been talking about this in a negative light, which I'm probably not gonna tap into because I don't really care, but which can also include vacationing in lavish places, going to lavish restaurants, buying lavish expensive things such as designer, very very expensive cars and things like that. I'll probably touch on it for a little bit, but not too much. And to be honest with you, I really think that black women deserve a lot. They deserve more, and I feel like that's something that we haven't gotten. A lot of people haven't showed us this, from our parents to our siblings to our friends, our family. It's a great thing that we are able to show ourselves this. But I love the fact that black women are finally stepping up and showing themselves that they can have luxury, right? They're doing good things for themselves. However, the problem with this whole situation is, first of all, let's get into the name. Soft girl era. I don't know how nobody finds a problem with the name. Why in the world are we prioritizing the word soft? Everyone is not soft. Just like everyone is not hard. I feel like this is damaging and is problematic because not everyone is gonna be soft all the time and not everyone's gonna be hard all the time. Sitting here and just labeling yourself as hard and labeling yourself as soft is problematic because sometimes you gotta be hard. Sometimes you gotta be soft. And the thing is, I've seen some of my friends that are trying to be softer get themselves in situations where they gotta buck, but they can't because, oh, I'm trying to be soft now. You don't bust that bitch up out. Like, what do you mean you gotta be soft now? This girl just cursed you out. This person just cut you in line. This person just disrespected you. You have to stand up for yourself. That doesn't mean you gotta curse them out. That doesn't mean you have to resort to violence, but you have to stand up for yourself. And I'm not saying that the soft girl era tells you not to, but I'm saying there's a lot of people that partake in these movements, okay? Because this is not the first one. There's a lot of these movements that I can't think of off the top of my head that literally tell you, oh, don't do this, act like that, act like a lady. That's not ladylike. And then it tricks you into thinking, oh, I can't do that. If I do that, that means I'm messing up my process. And it's like, what the, like, what in the brainwash is going on? Like, blink twice if you're in trouble. You are in trouble. Can you even blink? Is that against the rules too? It's just strange. Of course, that brings me to my main issue with all of this. It's not genuine. If you're gonna change for anything, do it for yourself. Make sure it's gradual. Make sure it's in stages. Again, let's go back to the name. I said soft is a problem. Next one is girl. We are grown ass women, okay? I already had a problem with black girl luxury and I didn't even point out the girl part, but that bothered me too, but I'm gonna point it out now. Girl, we are grown ass women. Could we start putting woman in these words? Like black woman luxury, grown woman luxury. Like, it's just ridiculous. Like, y'all are not girls, we're grown ass women, I would hope. Lady, at least, could we use lady? And then of course, era. What do we know is associated with era? Temporary. This is just a metamorphosis. This is just a temporary time for you guys to say, oh, I'm gonna be soft for now. Okay, I'm gonna be soft for now. I'm gonna just do this for now and see where it gets me. I don't know why I gotta explain that this is a problem, but of course it's a fucking problem. Okay, y'all can't just be out here changing for now and then you're trying to act like this is a permanent change when it's not. That's not how life works. Les professeurs, okay? You have to want to change for you. You have to make it gradual and you have to make it stick, because next thing you know, it's gonna be a new trend. And then next thing you know, we back on F-R-E-E, that spells free, whatever the hell the lyrics are. I don't even know the fucking lyrics because I was never on that shit. But it's just like, why is it that Instagram, Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, back on it, what are y'all on? Why is it that social media really influences you guys that much that everything that y'all see, y'all gotta go out and do and replicate, that y'all live y'all lives to it? And don't say it's because it's inspiring. Don't say it's because it looks good. Don't say it because y'all gotta learn how to inspire yourselves. Y'all gotta learn that your life is just as good as these people on the internet whom you don't know. I don't have to say, like, I tell you, these motherfuckers be lying. They be lying. A lot of them are not upfront about the lives that they live. Okay, a lot of them that you're seeing that are living these luxurious lives, they spent a lot of time cultivating these lives. Some of them, first of all, I read this one article. She said she spent 15 years working before she worked up the lifestyle to be able to live this soft girl era of hers. 15 years. A lot of y'all literally 18, 19, 25 talking about someone, I'm living a soft girl life. What the fuck are you talking about? You're not living a soft girl life. You work in 3 jobs, sis. You're not living a soft girl life. You work a 9-to-5 every day, slaving away. You're in debt. You're tired as hell. Your boyfriend ain't shit, cheating on you, you're running whole missions. You're literally not living a soft girl life. Just because you be on your PTO to take vacations every other week does not mean you live in a soft girl life. That's another issue. A lot of y'all don't even know what the soft girl life is. Y'all think just because you're on vacation, you go to restaurants, you get dig down every day, that means you live in a soft girl life. That's not a soft girl life. The soft girl life is the epitome of relaxing. You don't answer to nobody. You chilling, literally chilling. You have no care, no stress, no nothing. Like, I literally saw somebody tweet and told us, I work 3 jobs in order to maintain my soft girl life. Girl, how? That's struggle. That's your struggle girl life. Y'all are stressing me out and I'm struggling to comprehend how the hell you think that makes sense. Okay, y'all need to learn reading and comprehension. Okay, now before I get to the rest of this video, like I said, this video is sponsored by Hood Charms and they did send me their Bodega Bubble Slides. Now, I absolutely love these. These are ridiculously comfortable. I wear them. like everywhere. Now I don't know what to do. Like, I want these to be house shoes, but I want to wear them outside. So I kind of wear them in both, but I hate indoor, outdoor shoes. Like, I hate when people wear outdoor shoes in my fucking house, even if it's me. Okay, even if it's me. Even if Sage fuck around and she try to slip outside, I'm like, girl, you gotta wash your feet. Like, I don't got time for that. So it's like, but these, yo, these are so comfortable. Like, I wear them all the time when I'm editing. If I have to slip out for 2 seconds, I wear them. Like, these are so amazing, okay? You could decorate them with the little things that people be putting in Crocs. Like, as you guys can see, they have the little holes in them. They go with whatever outfit that you want, because of course they have different colors. Different colors. And most importantly, like I said, they are black on business. They are located right here in Brooklyn. Where Brooklyn at? And the shipping is super duper fast. They also have charms that you can order to put on your little slides or whatever. If you guys want to place your order, make sure you guys head to their Instagram. It's right here on the screen at Hood Charms with a Z. That is Hood H-O-O-D Charms C-H-A-R-M-Z. Hood Charms with a Z. And you go place your order with them right now. So let's get back into the video. So, of course, right, no one ever tells you how to live the soft life, how much it is to live the soft life, how they even got to where they were. All it is, you go on TikTok, you go on Instagram, you go on Facebook, you go on MySpace, whatever, back page. And you just see these people watering their plants. You see these people with their dogs, their cats, their turtles, their snakes, whatever the fuck. And they're just like, soft life. You should too, black girl. Black girl, the world has abandoned you, black girl. And now, black girl, you get to live, black girl. Next slide, be like, I gotta get up for this one. Bad bitch. And I'm on it. Louis, Fenty, Gucci, Prada. But how did you get that shit? What you do? Do you work? Do you trap? Do you go to Dubai? If you know what I mean. Like, what is going on? Like, what did you do? Because word on the street is a lot of these people actually had to work for a long time. First of all, we all know black don't crack. A lot of these girls, they not young. They not young. They literally 35 looking 15. Okay, so it's like, why aren't y'all up front? Why aren't y'all up front? Let's be real. We all know that women do not get paid like men. Okay, we all know. We all know women no get paid. Black women don't get paid, okay? So the odds of them even getting a high paid job, the odds of them even saving enough to even live this lifestyle, the odds of them ever even getting to this point. Why are y'all selling these motherfuckers on dreams? It's one thing to sell people on black girl luxury, because anybody could buy a fucking Louis Gucci Dior bag. You'd probably be in debt for a couple months. But when you selling them on that lifestyle of like vacations all the time, Louis, Fenty, Gucci, Prada, yeah. Luxury items is one thing. I think we all know. All right, bitch, clearly I can't afford a $5,000 bag. Maybe I could finesse a nigga to buy it for me, right? But like, when you literally getting people to buy into like a $15,000 a month lifestyle, it's just like, and yes, I know a lot of people are gonna be like, okay, but shouldn't people know they can't afford that either? Yeah, but there's so many people out there that's literally getting extra jobs, literally killing themselves, getting loans. You'd be surprised, y'all. Thinking that they could amount to this lifestyle, thinking one day they're gonna get there, not understanding that a lot of these women are way older than they look. A lot of these women had to work their asses off for a very long time or had extremely high paying jobs that most black women don't usually get. Like, the odds of that is rare. And then on top of that, they're not ever going to say that. They're just gonna, That's the thing that really bothers me about it. At least with the whole black girl luxury, we know that the fucking bag costs $5,000, $10,000. Like, you see the shit. We know how much a plate costs. There's nothing necessarily to hide there, right? Like, but these other people, it's just like, what do you do? Like, a lot, like, we don't know what they do. And then, of course, we have the whole issue of a lot of people making it seem like if you're not soft, then you're barbaric. You're masculine. No one's gonna want you. No man's gonna want you. And it leads people that aren't as soft, or they're not realizing themselves yet, to think, oh, well, I mean, what's wrong with me? Should I change myself? Let me tell you this right now. Just because you're not soft doesn't mean you need to be hard, and just because you're not hard doesn't mean you need to be soft, if that makes any sense. In other words, be your fucking self. You do not need to change yourself for anyone but you. If you want to change, you change on your own volition. I will say that when I got with my man, I did make some adjustments and changes because I was already developing and changing for myself. I didn't sit there like, oh, I got a man now, let me be it. Me and my nigga talk like we friends. Like, that's my homie, okay? And that's my bee, okay? I'm his homie and he my bee. Like, that is my best friend, okay? At the end of the day, he knows how I am and I'ma stay like that, point blank period. He know what the fuck he got himself into. All right, like, it is what it is. And I feel like more people need to understand that if you're gonna change yourself to be with somebody or to attract somebody, again, your mask is gonna slip. That's, you're not gonna be able to hold that facade any longer. And most importantly, you're not gonna be happy. If you go and you change yourself because, oh damn, how am I gonna get a man? Oh man, how am I gonna get a woman? Oh man, well, how am I gonna be with anybody if nobody wants to be with me like this? Well, you're just gonna have to stay that way because the right person is gonna be there. The right person who loves you for you is there somewhere. You just haven't found them yet, point blank period. Stop listening to social media, especially social media, because Jesus fucking Christ, a lot of people do not know what the fuck they're talking about. Stop listening to these fucking people, because 9 times out of 10, they're literally just putting out content. This shit is a game to a lot of us. Let me just tell you, it's a game, it's a paycheck, and it's just content. It's just content. It literally is just content. Some of us actually care to inspire you. Some of us actually care to really speak to y'all. But a lot of people are just putting out content. This is a trend, this is an era, this is a phase, and most importantly, it's an aesthetic and it will pass. Next thing you know, there's gonna be another one in the next 6 to 8 months and you're gonna have something else to try to be, okay? So wait till this shit has sailed, okay? Work on yourself, go write a business plan, go do something, because this ain't it, all right? If you do not feel like you align with this, if you feel like this is making you feel bad and you feel like, you know, you just masculine, or this is not for you, you whatever, that's fine. It doesn't matter. If you wanna change for you, change for you. If you think that however you are today is literally hindering you, that's fine. But do not go changing yourself because of some internet trends. Jesus Christ, don't. Too many women fall into this whole trap of, oh, I need a man, I want a man, I'm gonna change myself for a man. And this is usually older women, right? So a lot of you watching this may be a little too young to understand what I'm talking about. Maybe you're not, right? You know, you get to that age over the age of 25. It usually hits when you're 25 and you ain't got a man, right? When you're single, you're like, damn, like, I'm never gonna get a man. Like, damn, I had my high school sweetheart, he left me. I went to this man that I really, really liked, and you know, it didn't work out. And I tried to revisit my old flings, that didn't work out, and now I ain't got nobody. How about if I end up to be 48 and I'm still by myself? Oh my God, you're still young. Jesus, when you're like 75 and you single, all right, at that point, it might be time to call it quits. And even at that, there's still people that be 80 and still finding love. Y'all need to stop it, okay? Y'all really do. And most importantly, you need to understand there's more to life than men. You don't see men sitting here killing themselves over us. They really don't. When it comes to this type of shit, they understand faking. I hope y'all know that. If you're gonna sit there and turn on your baby voice and try to dress more conservative and act like you're not masculine and act like you're not loud and rambunctious and won't turn up on Walmart if somebody cuts you in front of the line, and then eventually the mask flip and you turn up, yeah, they'll see right through it before it even happens. Because men are a lot more evolved than women on this type of front, especially black men, okay? So if you think you're about to put on a baby voice and try to snag you a man, they already got you beat by 10 fucking feet, okay? And they just dare to see what the fuck they can get before they head out. I kid you not. This is why a lot of y'all women be sitting there like, niggas ain't shit, I did all of this shit, and it's not working, and no, you're just dumb. I'm telling you right now, nobody's gonna tell you, but you just dumb. This is why a lot of y'all go on these metamorphosis chameleon, what are we gonna call it, bozo the clown ass phases, and then y'all blaming men. No, I'm gonna give y'all a round of applause for once, and that's enough. I'll never give y'all a round of applause again. I'm gonna give y'all a round of applause because y'all done evolved to peep bullshit very, very well. If you're gonna change yourself for niggas, niggas are gonna peep that you change yourselves for them and you're not being yourself, and then they're gonna play the fuck out of you, and they're gonna play a violin for you when you try to bitch, cry, and complain, because they know damn well you was trying to play them first. If you're trying to change yourself for a man, you're trying to play them, and then you're trying to play yourself. If you know damn well you're not like that, don't try to be like that. Life is hard. The soft girl era negates natural sense of order. I don't understand. This is why I didn't even want to throw in the black girl luxury conversation in there, because I really know, I don't know, for some reason I thought somebody, I don't know, I feel like somebody's gonna drop it down below like, what's the difference between this and black girl luxury? Well, black girl luxury is more of like a consumerist type of mindset that kind of feeds into a mentality type of mindset, while this is like a whole entire lifestyle type mindset that happens to dibble and dabble in a consumerism mindset that people use to attack it. And to be honest, I don't even see the consumerism mindset of the soft girl era being that big of a deal or a big part of it. The whole real problem I really have with this is that it kind of paints this whole scenario of life is supposed to be rainbows and butterflies, and whatever happens, black woman, you are not supposed to rile yourself up, and you're not supposed to basically jump to the defense anymore and be anyone's hero, etc., etc. And I get that to an extent, but at the end of the day, life is hard. Whether you're black, white, whatever, like, life is hard. Shit is gonna happen. And if you think you in your soft girl era, you're not gonna snap a couple times, nigga, what? Just because you in your soft girl era, nigga, you is gonna snap. Bad things are gonna happen to you. Shit is gonna annoy the fuck out of you. Just because you in your soft girl era don't mean that that shit not gonna happen. And mind you, I'm speaking from the fact that I know a lot of people that's literally sitting here trying to like, oh, I can't do this, I can't do that, I'm not da 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 da. So, soft girl era. And I'm like, nigga, I will fuck you up. Like, my damn self. I wanna see how soft you are, bitch. Irritating, you know? So it's just very strange, because why do y'all think that just because you in an era that you can't do anything, that you can't say anything, that life is not about to just hit you? Life still gonna hit you. Okay, just because you say you in an era, don't mean you really an era, ma'am. Okay? You ain't shit, bitch. Life still gonna hit you. Life's still hard. And at the end of the day, it is what it is. It's a hard knock life. Understand, if you're gonna go from literally being a pit bull to a shih tzu, you're gonna have a cognitive break. Yes, that's what I said. You're gonna go from a pit bull to a shih tzu, you're gonna have a cognitive break. You can't do that, okay? No one changes overnight. And again, if you're gonna change for other people, you're not really changing, and there's nothing wrong with you. If you tend to be on the more masculine side, that's fine. I'm more on the masculine side, oh well. But I'm a little hood masculine, feminine, like I got a lot going on. So what? Still got a man, got plenty of men in my day. It is what it is. You are who you are. Accept it. Every experience that you've had in your life makes you who you are today. Love yourself for who you are. Love yourself for all your experiences. Love yourself, and most importantly, forgive yourself. All the wrong you've done, all the wrong you may have done to other people, all the wrong you've probably done to yourself, it is what it is. Forgive yourself. If you feel like you need to apologize to people, apologize to those people. But don't you dare feel like you're a horrible person. Don't you dare feel like you need to change just because you're human. We're all human. Fuck that shit. Kill that noise. Evolve. But don't change. There's a fucking difference. Especially not on no day and night shit, okay? You got time. Relax. Live a little, okay? Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for listening to my real talk. And most importantly, make sure you guys go visit Hood Charms and place your order on your bodega bubbles. Like, share, subscribe, do all that. Make sure you guys go to my other channels. Yes, I have two other channels. Chronicles of a Joe channel is my channel where I talk about Haitian voodoo politics and folklore from a Haitian American perspective. And then I have my Anna B. E. Moore channel where I do personal content, story times, vlogs, stuff like that. So everything you need is linked down below. Make sure you get your merchandise, join my Discord, join the Patreon, do everything. Do everything. Just peek the description box down below, and I'ma see y'all next time. Bye!